Hello friends, you are most welcome to OJPRT, your favorite channel once again, and today I'm going to talk about the trends and technology. We are going to look here about the trends which are running the technologies on nowadays. Let's begin with this. First of all, I am going to tell you about RPA. It means robotic process automation. Actually, robotic process automation means the thing which you are giving the instruction that can be done by a specific task by any software or a AI based machine or a robot. So this is the RPA. The another thing is there big data. Big data is actually what? It is a huge collection of memory. Maybe it's petabyte, heptabyte, zeptabyte, and it can be modulate and do the research, marketing, products, customer, many things more we are gathering from this huge number of data. So that is coming under the big data. Big data is a huge number of data which is kept on the data warehouse, and from there we can access the useful data. But how we have to use such all kinds of data, they are the technologies basically they are using, that is all come under the big data. Hadoop and Spark are the two most famous framework for solving big data problems. The another thing is there intelligent app. If we are going to talk about the intelligent app, to chatbots, virtual assistant, and Google, Oracle, these all are the companies which are working on all over this intelligent app. So apps are pieces of software written off for mobile device based on artificial intelligence and machine learning technology aimed at making everyday task easier. That involves tasks like organization and prioritizing email, scheduling meetings, login, interaction, contents. It's like a simply you are using the Sky app. If you are using Sky app for the basic purpose of the just communicating in the online chatting, online classes, so these all kinds of intelligent app. Here you can just basically use this app for your special purpose. So now another is technology which is coming in trend, that is Internet of Things, IoT. It is a basically famous technology, and it is basically you are going to see in 2022 or maybe in 2023, because of everything, whether all your gadgets in your home where it's going to just manage by your Android phone or maybe mobile. It means you can able to access everything from your Android phone only. The things, for the example, fridge, TV, and calculator, fans, many things are there in your home. Everything is going to manage by your Android mobile. You can just one click the button, the gas will open, and you will just one click the button, gas will off. So this is the IoT technology where you don't have to simply go there and you have to switch off the fan, switch off the light. Everything is be inside the mobile phone. Everything you have to tackle out from your Android mobile phone. So this is a basic, very famous technology nowadays. It's in trend only. So now I am going to just say you one thing. The another is DevOps. DevOps, it means this is a odd one out in the first list. DevOps is a methodology that ensure that both the development and operations go hand in hand. Develop cycles. DevOps is a cycle specialized as on an infinite loop representing the integration of developers and operation teams by automating infrastructure, for the example, workflows, and continuously measuring application performance. If I will say directly, it is an analysis, and it is a how you have to do the analysis. The software is actually, it is manipulating everything here and just taking the analysis, market values, everything is analyzing by this DevOps. Okay, Angular and React, these are the two trending technologies nowadays. Basically, you are going to see it everywhere in the all companies of IT, basically generally. So I'm going to tell you about the Angular and React are the JavaScript based framework. The basic, actually the base of this work and the base of this work language is JavaScript. Actually, JavaScript is a platform of Java only, but here JavaScript is a language which is a base language, and from that only Angular and Reacts are working. So these two are the framework for creating a modern web application. Basically, it is used for the web application when we are using the internet servers, client. At that time we are basically using such all this Angular, React, and JavaScript. Using React and Angular are sorry Angular, one can create a highly modular web page, so you don't need to go through a lot of changes in your code base for adding a new feature. Angular and React also allow you to create a native mobile application with the same JS, CSS and HTML knowledge. Best thing I am going to tell you, that simply HTML, CSS and JS, this is a sufficient, but we have to make the website dynamic and just we can simply say attractive and working highly. So that's basically we use the Java, Angular and JavaScript. Best part, open source library with high actively communicate support. There is two kinds of basically, so open source are there and pirated are there. Open source are there and one is more where I'm going to tell you another one. So basically two types of basically platform available in open source. You don't want to pay anything, it is simply openly available. You can use anywhere and how you have to modify it's depend upon you. But if we are talking about the another one, so for that you have to buy. For the example, Microsoft is there, for that we have to buy it. But for open source we don't have to buy it. For the example, I'm going to give you simply the operating system of Microsoft OS Window, we have to buy it. And Linux we don't have to buy it, it's a open source. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the another technology, that is a cognitive cloud computing. This is a good things that it is architecture, it is training AWS, Amazon. Cognitive cloud is on extended ecosystem of traditional cloud and cognitive computing. It's due to this you can create cognitive computing applications and bring to the masses through cloud deployment. Cognitive computing is considered as the next big evolution in IT industry. It converts in human language and helps expert in better decision making by understanding by complexities of big data. Its market size is expected to generate revenues of $13.8 billion by 2020 and is one of the top 10 trending technologies to consider this year. Big brands such as IBM, Google, Microsoft, Cisco have already started implementation this next tech to gear up the upcoming markets. The another is augmented reality and virtual reality. Virtual is a real VR and AR. I am going to say you simply when you are watching the games, 3D animations and 3D movies, so it's just like for a virtualization only. Because of why, when you are using everything like a robot, see, when you are using the simulator for the testing purpose of the robot, so we directly cannot make the hardware for the robots. First we are giving the environment, their robots can perform the activities according to your code, and if it is performing originally, it's 100% clearly, so we are going to give the real body to them. So as for the virtualization purpose, we are basically using the simulators. So basically I'm going to tell you the virtual is real, VR and AR, the twins technologies that lets you experience things in a virtual that are extremely close to real or today being used by business all small size and shapes, but the understanding technologies can be quite complex. Medical students use AR technology to participate surgery in controlled environment. VR on the other hand open up newer avenue for gaming and interactive marketing. Basically we are using virtualization for the gaming purpose basically mostly. Now the base, I'm going to tell you the one thing, blockchain is suddenly now using because of the safe online payment gateway, but basically it is working on the cryptocurrency. Because of why? Because blockchain, this is the tech that power bitcoins, the whole new parallel currency that has taken over the world. Interestingly, blockchain as a technology has far reaching potential in everything from healthcare to election to real estate to law enforcement. Everything you are going to be seeing in the future, not in future, in just 3 to 5 years only, blockchain technology. Actually blockchain technology is what I am going to tell you simply, this is the medium to transfer the money safely through the internet because of high encryption, hash encryption, and some vulnerable things are there, which is very best for this. So may I tell you one thing, that cryptocurrency is a decentralized cryptocurrency, but your rupees is a centralized currency. If you are transferring your money, so first of all you have to create the wallet, and in wallet you have to transfer your current currency like a Paytm and like a just PhonePe. So in digital form you have to convert the currency, and after converting you have to buy the cryptocurrency from your current currency. Then that currency you have to transfer through that blockchain. Because you cannot be able to transfer the rupees, dollar, you have to change the crypto, you have to transfer cryptocurrency only, whether it is a Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, any kind of currency is there. There are number of crypto coins are there, you can use it. At last, I am going to tell you one thing. There is an artificial intelligence which is basically entrained, and AI basically everywhere aware about this AI, artificial intelligence. So it's coming in the deep learning also. AI existed even before the internet was born, but it is now that the data processing and compute power backbone becomes strong enough to sustain on entire technology by itself. AI is everywhere today, from our smartphone to your car to your home to your bank establishment. It is the new formal, it is normal, something the world cannot do without. So may I tell you one thing, AI is a huge field, deep learning is there, and many more things are inside this AI, artificial intelligence, and it can just running in all over the world in huge sectors, whether in, and mostly you are going to see in the big companies everywhere AI is working for making the artificial intelligence, robots, and many things. So I hope you have aware about now all these technologies in under 10 technologies in 2020, or it will same work in the 2020 up to 2022, because it is a really high technologies and it is giving best result for the future generation. So it, you are going to see in up to in 2022, whether after 2022 it may be something you are going to see the change, but recently this thing is working. But one thing is there which you will see fastly, that is a blockchain, because of safe secure payment gateway we are basically using the blockchain. So hope you like this video. Don't forget to subscribe this channel. In the coming videos I will just bring you some useful content for you, which is you are going to see, and hope you will like this video and share this video to your friends circle. So give me time for the next video. Bye bye, take care. We are going to meet you in another video. Have a good look.